I'm Josh with Prescott and Sons. Behind me is another sunroom with a sitting room, also a big deck that we add onto the back of a home. Just to explain the outside a little bit, this whole entire wall right here, if you can imagine it being shifted all the way back about 12 feet. What we did, we removed the outside low bearing wall. A lot of people say it can't happen, it's not able to do. Well, with a few engineered beams, a little bit of drawings, and like I mentioned before, by my background framing homes, it is possible, as you can see now. Luckily, the homeowner's home, so all these videos we take, and we try to share with y'all everything we do, you have opportunity to actually walk through the tour with me, with the homeowner, so I'm not making this stuff up. When we do what's right, we give a good price, and we treat people right. So you don't have to take my word for it. As you'll see in just a few minutes, you'll be able to listen to the customer. As we walk in, we're going through a set of double doors. We go into the sitting room. Just real quick, we added the rear deck, come on the back of the house. We're still going to pressure wash and treat this tomorrow. But just a little quick opportunity. Staircase coming down with the step lights that we added. Overlooking the pool, great view. As we go inside the sunroom, I want you to notice the skylights up in the ceiling. I want you to notice the vaulted ceiling that we're going to show you. The plans originally called for a flat 8-foot ceiling. That looked very boring. With the homeowner's permission, I asked about, hey, can we make it a vaulted? They was worried about the cost, and the way I explained it to them, if I put in a vaulted ceiling or a flat ceiling, my cost is going to be the same. I just think it'd be a great feature to add. When we go in, I want you to notice it was very great. Great idea. They love it. As we walk inside, like I mentioned before, the existing home had originally ended right here, had a single door, set of steps going down to a lower deck. Coming off the back of the house to 12 feet, we added the vaulted ceiling with the skylights. We added a closet for storage area. This is going to be playroom slash sunroom. With the view of all the extra windows on the back of the home, great view. Notice the pine flooring. We actually had this flooring. We actually had the flooring built and cut at a local wood yard. We installed it in. Coming off the sunroom, we go into the existing living room. We added the double 6-foot pocket doors, tied the new flooring into the existing flooring. Standing here in the master bedroom, we decided, hey, instead of just adding the sunroom, let's go ahead and extend all the way out additional 12 feet so you have a sitting room coming off the master. As you can see, we added another pocket door that slides into the wall, that goes into a sitting room. Originally, this wall was a solid wall. There was one door, two windows here. What we decided to do was, hey, let's flip the bedroom suite over to this outside wall. So when we flipped the bedroom suite, we added these two additional bedroom windows to make everything balanced. Coming into the sitting room, as you see, we carried the pine floors all the way through. Added another triple window. This tray ceiling is kind of funny. When the framers were here, they said, hey boss, there's no room to add a tray ceiling. And I'm like, what you mean? I know it can happen. And like I mentioned before, I grew up framing, so I knew how to do it. So, you know, I actually pulled my old tool out of the truck, spent about 2 hours with the framers. Here we go, tray ceiling. Another great thing we had, so when we added a tray ceiling, we talked about, hey, you know, the sitting room don't have no fireplace, don't have nothing in the corner, so we decided to add a fireplace. The mason's not quite done with the top, but all the top is going to be stone as well. The gas logs. So sitting room coming off the master, great view, looking over the deck, looking out through the woods towards the pond. Standing inside with Miss Emily Dazzell, like I mentioned outside, you don't just have to take my word for things. We're going to give Miss Emily opportunity while she has time. She's, you know, got some more important things to do. But great customer, great to work for. Her husband, they're great friends of ours.
Really enjoyed this project, really enjoyed some of the colors and ideas that she had with us. So we're going to give it to Ms. Edwin, give her opportunity to kind of explain her experience with Prescott Sons.
Well, we started, we had an idea we wanted to add on to our house, just to give us a little more space for children to have a play area, us to have some additional sitting areas to entertain. And the whole process went a lot smoother than I expected. I'm familiar with construction projects, and I thought we'd have a lot more hiccups than we did. So that was pleasant, and also it was good for us that Josh was out here almost every day checking on the job and making sure that all the subcontractors had clear communication about what was expected and what the plans were. So we were really happy with the end results and felt like things went very smoothly through the whole process. And we really feel like it turned out to be what we expected and what we thought the rooms would be. So we were very pleased with that.